weddings and events. Every week we compile a list of trending weddings and events and bring it here to discuss with you guys as a family. So this week, the trending topics that we have, over to you, Bisola.
Okay, so today we're talking about Wofai Father. Okay guys, you might be wondering, who is this Wofai Father? Wofai Father is a Nigerian comedian, actress, content creator and sports enthusiast. She's known for her hilarious skits and vibrant personality. With a lack of humor and a strong presence on social media, she has amassed a large following and gained recognition for her comedic talents. Wofai's unique style and relatable content have endeared her to different audiences, making her a prominent figure in Nigeria's entertainment industry. So Wofai Father has been in the industry for a very long time. She's very, very hardworking, and she also had a restaurant called Just That Fam.
Tried. I heard she has the nicest
Afang
soup in Lagos.
100%. Afang, no, it's a while. Okay, so something happened recently to Wofai. Wofai got married last weekend. So he was telling the friend that Wofai Father is older than the son. So, and the relationship is still, it's quite early. The relationship is up to 7 months. So,
time of the relationship I can understand, but what has age got to do with this? Like, we all know that age has never been a factor when it comes to marriage.
So many celebrities, like so many people are married, like that maybe I think
one that the one person.
Yeah, let's take a look at is it Paul Peter? Yes, Paul Peter Okoye. The wife is older than him. Make sure it's Peter. It's Peter. So okay, your wife is like almost 10 years older than him, and look at them, they are still happily married.
Yes, there are lots of couples.
So, and even both my father doesn't even look. She went 30 years old. I heard the dad was saying that she's 30. She's not 30, she'll be 34. She's 33 currently. I think she'll be 34 very soon. So she doesn't even look it. And the thing is that, okay, let's even agree, because most people, especially Yoruba people, they'll say, oh, they won't allow their son to get married somewhere that is older than them, because mostly it's because, okay, maybe because they feel like old women are very, very difficult for them to conceive. They feel like once you are old, like it's very difficult for you to conceive.
I thought it was because they felt like if you were older than the man, you would not be, submissive. Yeah.
This also is part of it. Like they feel like older women, they always find it difficult to conceive. So, but what my father has proven to them that she's fat, like she's pregnant.
Yeah, because they said she's pregnant.
So what's the issue?
Another congratulations.
Yeah, so what's the issue? Like I feel like. No.
I think the man, I feel the problem with the dad was that he wanted to be involved in everything, and because he wasn't involved, it just...
I think the dad also mentioned something like, oh, that the guy, like, the groom, like he has a child somewhere. He won plenty for the child and all of that. So I just don't understand, but in all, I wish Wofai father all the best.
Yes, we also heard that the groom's parents have been divorced.
Yes, because so the mom was there.
The mom was present at,
The wedding. The mom was
it seems
present.
Like the groom grew up with his mom because she was very supportive all through. And if you are divorced and it's the mother that has been there all his life, you don't expect him to like take you so seriously on his wedding day to be.
Because he mentioned that the guy came to him, you know, the groom came to him, talked about the wedding, but it was not said, not time yet. At least it came
who
to
are you to tell somebody when it's time for them
it's
to marry?
It's not time that you should allow Wofai to give birth first. After the old thing, they can now get married. They mind
the way
now.
The dad is doing.
They mind so, now.
The way the dad is doing, I'm sure he's the one that told him that go and until she's pregnant first before you can talk about marriage. Mm-hmm. You know how some of your parents do that thing? They're like, I don't want to hear about
marriage until she gets pregnant. So my own is that Mrs. Cole of Toya Island, that's Mrs. Cole, Wofai father, congratulations. So yes, I'm happy Cole. That whatever makes Wofai happy, that was me I am for.
You know my favorite part of all of this, in the midst of all this drama and everything, she was so important. She kept posting her wedding pictures back to back.
And she posted her mother, you know. Even the groom is twin, they posted on Twitter, oh, congratulations to my sister-in-law, you know.
Yeah.
Dad, Mr. Cole, I'm sorry.
We're sorry. Clearly, whatever it is that you're feeling is not really
just
taken seriously.
Just welcome her, don't worry, people will enjoy Wofai. She's a very good girl, she's so
sweet. I mean, she's the best
she's
wife.
Sweet, like, I've met Wofai. Trust me, she's a sweet person, 100%.
I feel like she's the best wife you could ever ask for. She's hardworking, she's talented. She's not going to be waiting around for your son to come and take care of her. She's going to be out there doing things to make sure that her family is okay. And what that kind of thing? What other qualities are you looking for in a wife? I don't know.
And she can cook.
So, our next trending gist that whom that we're doing Amebo on is Vicky James. Vicky James is a Nigerian fashion designer known for her innovative designs and bold aesthetic. With a passion for creativity and a keen eye for detail, she has quickly made a name for herself in the fashion world. Vicky's pieces often blend traditional African elements with modern trends, resulting in captivating and dynamic collections. As she continues to evolve and expand her brand, Vicky James is poised to become a prominent force in African fashion. Vicky James recently got married about 2 months ago.
Yes,
in February. Yes, it was me. It's about
two months ago. Yeah, 2 months ago.
Yes, her marriage was the talk of the town. If you missed it, we're sorry.
Where would I be without you? 'Cause friends are.
just miss it because it was in our eyeballs all day, every day.
If you miss it, you can just go and check on Instagram. What's the hashtag again?
I don't know. Check our page.
Can just
check our Instagram page. We followed them back to back. We're chasing them
from introductions.
We chased them. Everything we followed. We followed them so much that even people were begging her.
Okay, so what's the test
you do? Anyway, after her wedding, she did Thanksgiving, everything. It seems like every week there's a new video or new picture of Vicky James and her husband posting something all the time. Now, this last week, she went again to church for a second wedding Thanksgiving.
I'd like to thank Apokoro Assembly for coming all the way to support us during the wedding. We received all the gifts. I am so grateful. I want to thank God for my husband, Femi Atere. I say it all the time that he's the best man I have ever known or I've ever seen. He's the best man. The best man in this world. When the Bible talks about humility, this is him. A man of peace. A man of virtue. And I give God all the praise for teaching me how to make the best decision in marriage, because this is my gift. And babe, I want to say thank you so much for being such a great partner to me.
That's where she grew up. She went to the church where she grew up.
Yes, in Ajegunle. She went for a second wedding Thanksgiving, and people on the internet are screaming. They said, Vicky, please.
No, I think they were screaming because they said the husband was quiet.
It was quiet, yes, she was giving both of thanks.
But like, people are not the same.
Yeah. And besides, her husband seems like a very quiet
person. What do you want to say? Like, what were you guys expecting him to say? To interrupt the wife? Because obviously,
you know what they said? They said he's supposed to be the one doing the vote of thanks, not her. Because he's the head of the house.
Oh my God, you guys! Like, really?
You people and your expectations.
Like,
people expect so much.
So she's a very easy, and the husband is a very quiet person.
Yeah. And in their relationship, you can tell
him to be doing what he doesn't want to do.
And you can obviously tell in their relationship that Vicky is the one that is outspoken,
exactly,
likes
so
the attention, does everything. I won't be surprised if her husband was saying one, she has said the 15 that he must say his mind. She'd be speaking his mind all the time.
So mind your business.
Anyway, that is what trended, that was what happened. Let us know what you think about the two events that happened, about Wolfie's story. Is that all the things that happened with Wolfie? Basically.
Yeah, that's all.
That's all. So yeah, let us know what you think about Wolfie and also Vicky. If you think Vicky is doing too much or if you think they should let her breathe.
Exactly.
Yeah. So anyway, thank you guys for joining and watching this week's Sugar News. And we hope we are bringing the gist to you.
Exactly.
Yes.
So no worries. Next week
we'll have more gist, hopefully. Mm-hmm. So don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment. All right, guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Bye.